almost without ceasing, I have been praying for you. And then he says, this is what I've been praying, that the God, in verse number 17, of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. Oh, let me just read it because I'm ready to stop it every sentence here. Let me just go and read it and come back. The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also that which is to come, and hath put all things under his feet and gave him to be the head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him that fills all in all. And you hath he quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins, wherein times past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he has loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace you are saved. By, boy, my God, by time you get there Sunday, Jesus, and hath raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. I'm going to be talking to you from a subject title, The Ascension Dimension. The Ascension Dimension. The Ascension Dimension. We're going to be dealing with that. Now, I deal with some of this in this book called Take Back Your Authority. Because the Spirit of the Lord has been dealing with me and awakening me so that I can awaken you to the fact that we don't understand fully how God sees us. You have to understand that something of duality was happening in this room while we were worshiping. The worship was just amazing. All of the prophetic worship in just amazing. And while I was there getting caught up in it, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and says, something is happening in this room that you don't understand. And he says, while y'all are worshiping me and glorifying me and dancing with me and dancing the victory and all of those things, he says, we are up here looking at you, thinking the same thing that you are thinking about us. Oh, my God. Which means you might not see yourself the way heaven sees you. Which is why the Bible declares in the book of Hebrews that we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. And your Bible declares that they're literally trying to peer into a dimension they were not privy to, but you and I get to live in. And that while heaven is saying, I want you to rejoice about me, oh, you don't understand, I'm rejoicing over you. I am rejoicing over you because you have no idea who you are. And so there is a duality that's going to be happening in here all weekend. There is going to be angels ascending and descending. There's going to be praises going up to heaven and revelations coming down from heaven. There's going to be worship going up and God sending affirmations back down. To the degree that the moment you look at him and say, oh my God, you are holy, you're going to hear him immediately say, and you are too. Oh, this is some, oh my God. This is some strong stuff now. But see, the reason I'm here, thank God for the man and woman of God who says, I've got to get this revelation to my people. They brought me here for you. Because they understand where God is taking the body of Christ. We have shifted out of a religious wineskin and we are going into the fullness of God.